So for the today's lecture, what we are going to study is US use case diagram, but this is just a part one in which I'm going to talk about the use case. What is the use case? Why we are using use cases? What is the purpose? Who are the people who are going to benefit from this use case? And then I'm going to move to what is use case diagram. Okay, so moving on. First thing, first question that arises in our mind, that is, what is use case? So use case is simple. It is just a description, right? This is just a description of how a person who actually uses the process or system will accomplish a goal. What does this line mean? This is very important. How a person who actually uses that process or system will accomplish a goal. For example, there is a point in which ATM machine is there and I am the person who is going to interact with the ATM machine. That is a system, right? I want to withdraw certain amount from that ATM machine, right? Through the card, obviously. Fine. So I am the person who is actually going to interact with the machine. Fine. My goal is to withdraw the cash, withdraw certain amount of cash. Fine. Now, what process I'm going to follow? This description, all these steps, that is inserting a card, giving the PIN, feeding the actual amount, and then receiving the cash, and finally receiving the receipt. So this particular process, these particular steps are going to be included in this use case to accomplish a specific task or to accomplish a specific goal. And there is a person who is interacting with this system. We have to think of that also. So that particular person is considered to be an actor. Fine. So this process is what, this is the description of use case. This is how the use case are defined, not designed, first thing. It's typically associated with software systems, but can be used in reference to any process. Fine. We are going to use this particular as in software systems, but it can be applied to anywhere because these are simple use cases. Fine. Now, when I define in simple terms use case, so it is just going to tell you that what behavior it is going to show. That means what is expected from the system. What processes will be included, fine. But it is not going to tell you what method we are going to use to do a specific process, fine. As I told you in the earlier example, I am talking about an ATM machine inserting a card, right? I'm just saying that card is being inserted. I'm not giving the complete detail how that particular card is inserted. I'm not getting into the technicality. I'm just giving the process, inserting of a card. Right? So logging process, I'm not going to give the detailed fact how the logging process is going to accomplish, right? So I'm only talking about the expected behavior. I'm only going to specify it. I'm not going to give the exact method behind that, right? So it is going to answer what processes, but not how the processes are going to take place. Fine. So next thing is use cases are and can be denoted in both the forms, one as textual and one as visual representation. So whatever visual representation we all know is called as the use case diagram, but we are unaware of the fact that use cases are also drawn as textual. So that is why we are not going to say that these are designed, but these are defined. So the use cases are defined when it is in textual format, and use cases are designed when in use case diagram format, that is in visual representation. Fine. Now, what is the origin of use case? I'm not getting into very detailed fact of the history of use case, but I'm just going to tell you that before the existence of today, we all know this particular use case in terms of UML, right? In terms of unified modeling language, it is associated with that. But for your information, I'm going to tell you that this particular use cases were way back used by Eivor Jacobson in 1986 when UML was not there even. Fine. So Eivor Jacobson was the person who first formulated the textual format of the use cases and used in the modeling format also. And he has a, you know, book which is co-authored as Object-Oriented Software Engineering, in which what he is doing, he is popularizing the fact that these particular are used for capturing the functional requirements and the when we are going to develop a software. Fine. So this is the basic agenda and the basic goal of use cases. That is what we are going to do. We are going to get or capture or identify or collect the functional requirements about the project or the software we are going to develop. So use cases have this particular goal as the first and the priority one. Fine. Now, what is the purpose of use cases? We have number of purposes. What are these? I have just highlighted it in the short forms. A use case is a methodology which is used in system analysis when a business analyst is there, right? So business analyst is the one who is going to define the use case, who is going to define the use case and going to prepare the textual form of the use cases. Fine. So it is used where? It is used in system analysis. Now we all know that system analysis is the one who is going to, you know, identify all the requirements, identify and clarify and organize. So next thing I have written, it helps to identify, clarify and organize system requirements. As the fact we all know that requirement is the first and the foremost thing which should be very clear to the developer, to the analyst and to the end user, so as to design a software which seems to be a successful one. Fine. Until and unless all the requirements are being fulfilled by the software, the end user will not be satisfied. So for the satisfaction of end user, all the requirements should be included in the software. So the first and the foremost thing is to identify all the requirements of the system which is going to be designed and defined. So we need to identify, clarify and organize these requirements. Next point, the use case is made up of a set of possible sequences, right? So as in the earlier example also, I just gave you that inserting a card, logging account, then feeding the amount, withdrawing the cash and so on and so forth. The simple process, it is a set of possible sequences which is going to be defined in the use case so as to establish what the requirement is for the actor, for the user. It shows the interaction. It shows the, one more thing, that we have a possible sequence of set, but it does not give you a specific order of these sequence of processes. That means in the sequence diagram, we have a particular order of processes which is going to take place in the specific order, right? But here it is just a set of possible sequences, but it is not going to give you the numbering or order of that. This is the first process that is going to happen, second, third and fourth, right? Next, it is going to show you the interaction between the system and the user in a particular environment. So the same example, if I take about the ATM machine and the let's say I'm withdrawing the cash, so I am the user and I will be termed as the actor for the use case diagrams, and system is what? System is the machine. Fine. It is related to a particular goal. Obviously, whenever there is a use case scenario, it will have a objective, it will have a goal for which we are going to design the sequence of processes to establish that goal. So these are the purposes of use case. Now, who are the people who are going to benefit from these use cases? This is very important. First thing, we have already seen that business analysts are going to identify and collect all the system requirements. So this is a very important task for the business analyst. use case is going to give you a clear understanding and will help you to identify, when I say you, I mean to say business analyst, identify and collect the complete requirements of the system or the software we are going to develop, so as to take a point that we do not miss any of the requirements. Next one, it is helpful for the developer also. How it is helpful for the developers? See, when we say that we have collected the requirements, we have gathered the requirements for the project we are going to define or design or to develop, that means those particular requirements are acting as the functionalities of the software. Fine? As an example, if I say that a user wants a library management system software in which he or she can, you know, return the book, issue a book, can get to know what is the pending book he has, what is the, you know, penalty he has if he has given back the book late. So all these are the requirements of the user, and these particular are going to act as the functionalities for the software, right? So issuing of the book, this is a functionality of library management system. Returning of the book, so that particular process is what? That is again a functionality. So all these requirements which are gathered are being converted into the functionalities of that software. So it is very helpful for the developers to get the clear understanding what functionalities are to be included in the system and what should be the final outcome of those processes. Fine. It is very important for the testers also. How it is important for testers? Let me tell you that according to the use cases, the testers can formulate the test cases to have the better testing process. Fine. To easily test the software so that he or she, the tester, is not going to miss out any code which remains untested, any module which remains untested, because it depends on the test cases they are going to use, they are going to formulate. So according to the test cases, according to the use cases, these particular test cases are generated, which are very helpful for the tester to know what the end user wants from the system, what should be the outcome of the system. Fine. So moving further, now we have already talked about what is a use case. So that was all for the use case. Now we move to the point, that is, what is a use case diagram? See, we have already seen whenever we are designing that particular description of sequence into a visual formation, into a visual representation, that particular is what is the use case diagram. It has certain notations which are going to be used. What it is going, it is showing what? So the key concept is what? The key concept of use case modeling is, it helps us to design a system from the end user's perspective. That I have told you, that this use case diagram is designed according to the perspective of end user, not as the perspective of the developer or the analyst or anyone, but with the perspective of end user. And end user perspective, we all know, is very important when designing the, when developing the software. Now, it is an effective technique. It is an effective technique for communicating system behavior in the terms, in user's term, by specifying all externally visible system behavior. That means whatever the system is, all the external elements which are going to interact with the system, it is going to give you a complete communication process of those. Use case diagram only summarizes some of the relationships between use cases, actors, and systems. That we have already seen, that it is not going to tell you how that particular process is going to take place, but it is just going to summarize the relationship between the use cases that we have defined, the actors, and the system. Next, it does not show the order in which steps are being performed to achieve the goals of each use case. So it is just going to tell you what processes it is going to follow, but to achieve the goal, but it is not going to give you the order of the sequence. Fine. So next thing, we have already talked about the diagram, use case diagram. We need to say where it is. It is lying under the category of what? Under the category of behavioral diagrams. So behavioral diagrams are the dynamic diagrams. These are not the static ones. We have seen that behavioral are the dynamic ones, while structural are the static ones. I'm repeating these particular this particular slide in all of my diagrams, so as to give you a clear concept and to give you a continuity of the broad classification of the diagrams between behavioral, that is dynamic, and structural, that is static. So use case are falling under the category of behavioral diagram. Fine. Now, what is the purpose of use case diagram? We have seen the purpose of use cases. So similar is the impact of use case diagram. The only difference is what we are doing. We are going to give these particular use cases as what? As the concept of visual representation in the diagrams. Fine. So what we are going to see here is use case diagrams are typically developed at the early stage of development, and people often apply use case modeling for the following purposes. What are the purposes? First thing, it is helpful in specifying the context of the system. Obviously, it will tell you what the context is all about. Let's say if it is only talking about the bank status, that is only about the saving account, so it will give you about the specify the context. Next one, it captures the requirements of the system. We have already talked about this particular point, that it is going to identify and capture all the requirements of the system. Next, it is going to validate a system architecture. System architecture is being validated by the use case diagrams, because it has been designed according to the end user perspective. Next one, it drives the implementation and generate the test cases. Now this we have talked about. Capturing of the requirements and validating a system architecture is the point that helps the business analyst. I have told you in the earlier slides the benefits people are attaining from the use case. Driving of implementation is for the developer, right? For the coder, while generating of test cases is for the tester. So I think you must have taken a clear understanding of this concept, that use case diagrams are not only helpful in the designing part, it is helpful for the analyst, for the developer, as well as for the tester. Lastly, it is developed by the analyst together with the domain experts. When we talk about domain experts, we are about to say that the person who is expert in designing all these diagrams in the now. Now you see, I have just shown you the use case diagram at a glance. When I say at a glance, I mean to say that this is a basic use case diagram, use case in which we have shown that there are certain things which are we are going to use. First thing, this is an actor. We have already talked about actor, and we are going to see in the next lectures what is an actor, how to define or identify the actor, and so many more things. But this is the representation, visual representation of an actor who is going to interact with the system. This square box, this rectangle box is the system. And within the system, there are number of use cases. So that is being shown in the oval box. There can be number of use cases, and there can be number of interactions between the actor. There can be one actor, there can be multiple actors, and there can be number of use cases which are interacting. And what is this? This is the line, or this is the link of association or generalization, or I'll say this is the link which is going to show the communication or the interaction between the use case and the actor. So that is what the use case is in a simple format. Now see, we have taken a use case diagram in the library system. I'm not going to explain it in very detail, because I'll just explain you the complete notations, the complete visualization, and the formation of the use case diagram in next lecture. Okay, so this is the library user, is the actor. One more is actor is there. It can be named as librarian or the administrator. There are certain use cases, register of book loan, register book return, query book availability and add new book, etc., etc. Now these are the things which are showing the interaction point. Add new book, librarian is only going to interact with this process. Why? Because the user is not going to interact with this process. If a new book comes in the library, the librarian is going to add the book. So it is going to use the process. So that is why the interaction point of this particular use case is only with the librarian, not with the library user. Now there can be multiple roles of this library user. It can be as an instructor, as an professor, as a student, etc., etc. So that we will discuss in the further lectures, how we are going to define different roles for different actors. And this is the system boundary. This rectangular box is forming as a system boundary, as the library system. This is the system. Fine. And in this we have four processes. So that is what use case diagram is defined in the way. Now see, this is a use case. This is the textual format in which the business analyst is going to define the use case. And this is the visual formation of the visual representation of the use case when we talk about, and it is termed or called as the use case diagram, right? This is called as the use case diagram, while this is termed as the simple use case, which the business analyst is going to define in a textual format. So thank you. That's all for today's class. In the next lecture, we are going to talk about how we are going to design the